Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everyone, depending on where you are. I'm delighted to welcome you all in our next round of PCB webinars. I am Alba Keçal, the organizer of today's webinar. Please be informed that starting from today, we will organize risk and management webinars every Thursday from 3 p.m. Central European time. We will introduce to you the hottest and newest risk topics from which you can gain a lot of information and be part of live discussions as well. Today, we will introduce to you a very popular and requested topic, the increasing project success through project management maturity based on 21500. The topic will be presented by John Roos, the project program manager on a consultancy basis. He has an extended experience in many fields, including business improvement, the 21500, and total quality management. The presentation will start with a short introduction of the project management methodology based on ISO 21500 and continue with PM maturity and PM organizations. Finally, the results of project survey, including facts and findings, will be demonstrated. Before starting, I would also like to remind the audience that during the webinar, you can write your questions in the chat box in your control panel, and in the end of the presentation, Mr. John will answer to them. If you do not have time for all the questions, kindly be informed that your questions will be answered through email. Thank you very much for your attention. John, you may start the presentation.
Hello, everyone. This is John Roos, and we start with the webinar. So if you're here, I was already introduced. I'm a certified PCB project manager, trainer, and lead auditor, and lead implementator. And my working experience is more than 25 years in widespread of branches. And I have done a master degree on project management. The agenda is introduction, definitions, hypothesis, finding facts, tips for predictable project success, and questions. Why? Why project management? It is easy. You have regular work in a company environment, and change management is more or less a common way of working, because the world is always changing, and therefore we need, and it is important to have a project management methodology, and that is the reason why project management. The benefits for that is that you can make a project organization and put all the stakeholders together. So you have short lines, short communications, and short action lines and progression and possibilities for control the processes. The structure of ISO 21500 gives you a standardization, a structure. So for the communication, to work with each other, with vendors or subcontractors or other people in your organization, it is nice to have a common and structure and communication line. Therefore, project management, and like for example, ISO 21500, could be very important for supporting the business change. And I've already said to you, the business change is more and more important, because change management, changing the world around us, is permanent there. Project failure. If you read papers, if you talk with your colleagues or with other companies, project failure is a very common issue and topic on holidays or management board meetings, and on the internet you find a lot of stuff. But 6 or 8% is now the outcome of project failure. This means if you invest $1 or €1, you lost 60% or 80% from that euro. And do you think by yourself if your wife or self or your children spend this housekeeping money on that point and lost from every euro or dollar 60 to 80%, you say, are you crazy? This is, how can you spend a lot of money and why the failure? Do something about it. And the strange thing is that in the management board, the question is not on the agenda. It is more or less common, and I have not an answer why. But you will see we lost a lot of money, and we can save a lot of money if you introduce a project management standardization and get more mature. So the ISO 21500 can help you. And therefore, ISO 21500 can be the strategic tool to save money and get efficient projects and increasing your projects. ISO is international standard, so you can use it worldwide. Everyone understands it and can understand it. ISO facilitated international, so if there's there are changes or more development or new items, you get the information. The standards contribute more effective and safe and clean business for you. And if you already have a project management standard at your own, you can use it as a quality system for how to measure your project performance based on the ISO 21500. ISO 21500 is also familiar with the other international project management methodologies. In worldwide, we have four international project management methodologies. We have in the side of the USA, Asia, more PMI. In the Scandinavia, the international competence baseline, and in Europe we have PRINCE2. And now, the latest years, we have also ISO 21500. But ISO 21500 is familiar with and based and built on the international competence baseline, the PRINCE, and quality management systems and risk management. So if you make a choice for ISO 21500, you have all family project management in your scope of the methodology. This means an international standard and with shared knowledge and processes. For what type of organizations? Project management is project management. I have always the discussion about methodologies. And then we have discussion, methodology A or B or C, what is better? Nothing is better. Project management is project management. Project management exists about preparation, thinking about it, then decide how you will execute it, implement it, and then finally have a party and closed project. But ISO is a very useful instrument for any kind of organization, and what I told you before, it is familiar with the other international standards. Also, ISO is very acceptable in technical environment because they know and they work longer than other consultancy organization or banking organization or insurance organization with ISO methodology and quality criteria. So ISO 21500 is very interesting. The choice of ISO have an imperative character. And this is the difference between the other familiar methodologies. the international components baseline and Prince 2 don't have an imperative force corrector. You are free to do it. It is your choice. And what you see in the practice, the people learn and take over the standard and make finally an own book of this large version. But ISO said, no, you have to implement it in your organization. It is part of continual improvement, and therefore you have to implement it also the PDC, a quality circle of Deming. So after every project, you ask, okay, what was the lessons learned? What have we did wrong, false? And how can we get it successful for the next time? So therefore, you improve your project management organization, you get more and more mature. And by more maturity, you save a lot of money. So the ISO 21500 projections can help your organization to get a higher maturity and read quality. The average cost of reduction is 30%. So with a good preparation in the pre-tender or in the pre-sales, pre-project phase, and you use the ISO 21500 quality check, you minimize the risk of project failure. It is almost the same as on going on holiday. If you are not prepared to go on holiday, you get surprises in your suitcase when you arrive in the country because you have forgotten something. But if you prepare your holiday on a well matter, you have no surprises. You have to take risks. You have to make a project plan, traveling plan. You have questions, and you know about the locations, the quality about the location, the expectations are clear, and the criteria are clear. This is why ISO 21500 can help you. Well, other more benefits. It is improving quality. It will be widely recognized. It is a knowledge and transfer of knowledge between projects and organizations. It is integrated with specific standards. It is part of continuous improvement. Business continuity and business hygiene is a part of that. And ISO 21500 is a diagnostic tool for assurance and assessments. And self-assessment, I can advise you, because if you sit together and you have a workshop about the diagnostic tool, then you learn something about the project, and the next time you don't do it again. And if you have reached the 21500 certification, you can really celebrate this achievement, because it is a very nice and tough and very good standardization who is familiar with the PRINCE2 and the IPMA, or the International Competence Baseline. And if you have got your certification, you need to tell, and you can tell to your friends, your employees and other stakeholders of your accomplishment. You can use it as a marketing sales tool, because sometimes you get the question, can you prove how you can manage my project or the project? Then you can say, yes, I can prove it because I'm ISO 21500 certified. I have a proof, I have a certification that shows that I am a specialist in project management. It is not a guarantee, but it helps. And you can save easy money for each company and reduce the mistakes of project failure. The picture, project management maturity, there are five levels. All organizations struggle more or less at the initial process. ISO 21500 is level 2. And if you embedded it in your organization and use it in as continue improvement and take the lessons learned serious, yeah, it is much easier to go on a level 3, 4, and 5. And then finally, you are more or less excellent in doing project management. What do you see in the practice? What are weak metrics and what are strong metrics? The functional weak metrics is that authority of project management is allocated to the functional managers, not project management. The project and the team managers are most of the time part-timers, flexible labor policy. If they do the project and they leave your company, they are losing the knowledge and experience. So no lessons learned and PDCA circle are embedded. Well, this is a strong metric, metrics. That authority is allocated to resources and with project managers and not functional managers. That the project management and the teams are full-timers, fixed contracts. And that the lessons learned in the PDCA circle are embedded. So they are not walking out the company. The hypothesis, this is the subject of my certifying Master of Project Management, CD. The hypothesis was project undertaken with organization with a higher level project management maturity, consistently before better told lower level maturity. Predictable project management is possible with a higher maturity level, as I want to prove it. I have studied 200 participate organization, widespread in all branches. If you Google on the internet or Google by Google and you type project failure, you see a lot of studies with an end result. But now the latest study is that 2.5% of the companies had 100% of the projects within budget to scope and delivering the right benefits. This means that more than 90% are not satisfied of the project and didn't get any good results. And worldwide, with project cost and indirect cost, project failure is estimated at cost $3 trillion. That is a lot of money. And if you are trained and you have standardized, you get more maturity and you can save maybe 1, 2, 3, or 3% of average more project success, you have a business case for investing in project management training. Because if your company are losing or get benefits of from 1% of project failure, it could be already the benefits, the business case for justifications for training and make a choice in standardization. Other questions so far? Now I'll go further. An higher maturity level will in most cases superior performance in terms of project delivery of business benefits. When I asked, the superior project management first was seen as follow. Benefits of return of investment, more stakeholder satisfaction, on-time delivery, on budget delivery, and quality expectations. Quality expectations, a lot of people and organizations forget it to make it smart. they say, okay, we have some expectations, but where are the criteria? A lot of people, for a lot of organizations, for a lot of project managers, forget to ask for the quality criteria. And they must be smart. In a lot of organizations, project management have an informal way of working and is not standardized. And this is maybe the explanation of unsuccessful projects. The maturity of the companies, what I've seen, is between maturity level 1 and 2. They are not standardized. The organization who are not satisfied with the maturity level, it was more or less 60%, have spoken the risk to arrive at a higher maturity level. And they have found that a lot of project failure was outside of the project manager. Because from the year 90s, we have a lot of certifications, certified project managers. But the companies are not trained in project management. It's not a normal way of working. It's not a daily way of working. And how higher the alignment between organization structure and business needs, how higher the project performance of the organization. So you have to find the right balance. You need also to develop your staff and train it, because untrained staff are related in the project management performance. So untrained personnel are serious risks on your project. You don't be afraid about investing in the people. As I said already, untrained people are significant project risks. So you have to train them if they are part of the organization, of the project organization. They have to know what they have to do and have to know the consequence if they do something wrong. Change management must also be integrated in project management. And therefore, you need clear criteria, clear change management processes, and a clear structure. A project management office can help you for get more project professionalization. It can save money on project management, because with a good support, and senior project management can do more projects, so you can save the expensive specialist on project management. And they can help you with standardizations on template, resource questions, and make minutes, and that sort of things. Project management office can do that, so that the specialist can work permanent on his projects. Finally, we have found several points what can help you to get project predictable success. And we have found about in the discussion and in the study that if you have good sponsorship and a result different staff, involved end users, and clear sponsorship of the steering committee, clear and smart end results and targets, realistic planning, realistic expectation, and short project stages, and competence and trained prime staff and ownership, if you reach this all, you are so far to get a certain predictable project management. And that you can reduce your project failure with an average of 30%. Project management is also a change. It is not always a technical change. By a change of a company business and business improvement and a new vision and new strategy, people are involved. So you have to take the people with you. So you have to communicate and about the urgency of the change. The people have to understand why. Form powerful coalition. And that you can do that with a strong project metric structure. You have to communicate a great vision for change. Like, this is the current situation, and if we not change the company or save money, we are losing jobs. So the vision of the change will be so that people can understand the urgency and that they can accept it. But what you are doing, there are always obstacles. You get to try to speak with them. You can explain it again. But finally, you have to remove them. There are really risks for a change. Create short terms of wins. Give you some credit for the change and in your organization. Build on the change. Talk with the end users and let them part of the change. Anchor the change in corporate culture and in the sense of business improvement, continuous improvement, learn from your mistakes. And finally, train on the necessary competences. Because if the organization is changed, the work is changed, the people must be trained in the new situation. Before you can start with the project, or you can use this by the pre-sales or the tender, you can have a short quick review health check. And you can fill it in. And if you see it is more than red, than green, then you have to say, we have to do it over. And we don't go further. This is helping you and give you a quick health check for your project management pre-sales, or you can use this by the mandate or starting up or initiating a project before you say yes for implementing or realizing, or doing the project execution. Okay, thank you. Are there questions?
Thank you, John, for this highly informative webinar. I would like to ask the audience to please write down your questions now. In the meantime, I will start with the first question. The first question is, what problem-solving techniques do you use?
Say it again.
What problem-solving techniques do you use?
This is independent of the problem. And each problem has its own solving solutions. So I have to know what the problem is. If the person who said the question and can make it more concrete by email, or then I can give him the answer.
Okay, thank you very much. The second question.
I'm now also a project program manager in protection environment, and there are a lot of problems. culture, bureaucratic, they start too late, the business case was not clear. There are a lot of things is not correct. So I have 100 problems, and I need for each problem the right solution. And the answer is independent of the culture, the problem, the locus, the situation, the time, what you need, of what you have. So ask the people, the person who wrote this question, to send an email to me, and then I will give a clear answer to him for helping.
All right. So please take note. If you have any problem-solving problems, techniques, please write to Mr. John, and he surely will help you on problem-solving techniques. Thank you, John, very much for your answer. The next question is, can the project's critical path change?
Yes, of course. Why not? Because when you start a project, you make a planning at the situation at that moment. But yeah, the world has changed, and also the world is changing around the project management environment and the planning. Something can happen. And therefore, you have to replan your project, and then also the critical path can change. That could be the consequence.
Thank you, John. The next question is, can you give us some metric to measure project maturity?
Yes, I can. But I can send it by email in attachments.
Okay, thank you. And the last question for today is, what is earned value in project management?
Earned value?
Yes. What is earned value in project management?
Can you describe the earned value of project management in English? I don't understand the question.
Okay, this is the only question that I have now. If the attendee can explain more what he meant with this question, I would be grateful. We have an example here. It says, if we change critical path, should we change all business case and project initial document?
No, only the business. The business case it must be part on every stage and milestone. And of course, you have to look to the impact of the business case, and the business case can change. And if there are interfaces, if you are talking about as a program, and you have a lot of projects in the program, and there are a lot of independency of the projects and interfaces, the business case can change, but it is also independent how you're organized your project organization structure. If you have a program organization portfolio, then you have on the highest level and business case, and the business case are related or written in line of the highest business case. But if you have independent project management projects with own business cases with interfaces, it can change, but it is not always there. So it is independent of the situation and how you have to organize it and written down. There are a lot of solutions and hints and tips for it. So if the people, if the person have problem about it, of a specific question of his problem, I will answer his question by email.
Thank you, John.
But I need more background to answer this question.
Yeah, we understand. Thank you very much. In the meantime, I have here another question, which should be the last question answered because of the time limitations. It says that, what is the difference between critical path method and critical chain method?
Critical chains method?
Critical path method and critical chain method.
I don't know.
Okay.
I cannot give an answer.
Thank you. Thank you very much, John, again for this informative webinar. I would also like to thank the attendees as well who have taken time of their busy schedules to participate. I hope you all have learned something new today and your questions have been answered. I want to inform you that this webinar is also recorded and can be found in our website and in our YouTube channel. We will also send you the link of the webinar in your email in the upcoming days. Don't forget to check back on our upcoming webinars and topics of your interest by visiting our website www.pcb.com. Looking forward to seeing you all next week in the same time, in the same day. Until then, have a great week. Thank you, John, again very much.
Okay. Au revoir. Hello.